children laughter and remind us how we used to be. Good afternoon, viewers and subscribers. My name is Howard Wilson. Welcome to MPEG TV. Well, as you know, May is Child Month. It's a bit late for me to be doing this production, but it's better to be late than never. I hope all of you are keeping safe in spite of the trying circumstances we're going through. All right, today we'll be featuring a school in Spanish Town, other than Jonathan Grant High School.
I believe no matter what.
Approximately eight years ago, Jonathan Grant was blessed to have its new principal, Dr. O'Neill Ankle, otherwise known as Hurricane Ankle. Hurricane Ankle blew into Jonathan Grant approximately 8 years ago, blew out negativity. The climate had changed, the weather had changed, and it's the dawn of a new era for Jonathan Grant High School. Now, this proud principal, we're going to showcase some of the handiwork of this proud principal since he assumed his duties at Jonathan Grant. Being a part-time staff at Jonathan Grant, I like the atmosphere. I am the chess tutor at Jonathan Grant High School, and the school have come a long way, and have reaped a lot of success over these 8 years since Dr. Anka has been there. The school excel in many different areas. To name out all of the areas, then this video will be too long, and there are some clips that I want to show you. I was inspired to do this video based on some recent clips that teachers had put together. Really inspired me to put together this package to showcase Jonathan Grant High School. Such a school like this deserve for Jamaica to know about, deserve for the Caribbean and the rest of the world to know about. So I'm here to expose the positivity as it relates to Jonathan Grant High School in this video presentation. Now we'll start off the video presentation by showing you how happy Dr. Ankle was when they were celebrating some of their recent success. So we'll start off this presentation by showing you that clip. But I want to elaborate a little bit on one or two areas before we get into that. The chess. Now, Jonathan Grant traditionally is not known to be a chess playing school. They usually say intellects and nerds and all kind of stigma drawn to chess, but just about anybody can play chess. Chess helps you to be a better student, a better citizen. It has a lot of health benefits mentally and otherwise. It's now considered as a sport, and I'm proud to be a part of the Jamaica Chess Federation and a part of the Jonathan Grant family. Now, since I went to Jonathan Grant, I believe is in 2015. Now, Jonathan Grant has made a significant mark on the chess arena. Now, Jonathan Grant is now one of the schools to watch out for as it relates to chess. We are not where we want to be yet as one of the top schools in chess in Jamaica, but we are getting there. And we have had a lot of success over the past 5 years where we participated in the national schools competition, reached a second round twice. Just recently narrowly knocked out of the finals, but we intend to bounce back and come strong. Well, one of the things that have been affecting the program over the years is one, the shift system, and two, because traditionally we are not known as a chess school, parents usually tend to want their kids to go to some of the more popular schools like the Wilmers, the San Diego, and so forth, so that their student can continue their chess activities and who knows, become a national master or a FIDE master later on. So I want to enlighten the public that now you can send your, once you're living in close proximity to the school, you can now send your children to Jonathan Grant High School where they're in good hands. We have about 3 different teachers who impart the knowledge of chess to the students, including myself, and we are destined for greatness. And as you can see on your screen, some of the activities we have been participating in and some of the trophies we have won over the years. So now Jonathan Grant is a force to reckon with in chess. We are very competitive when we compete against the likes of Campion College and San Diego, just to name a few. We are very competitive, and persons are now giving a keen eye on us, and you know, they are marveled as to the level of chess Jonathan Grant is now playing. So we have had instances where students have been transferred from grade 7 because they think their chess future will be non-existent at Jonathan Grant. But I want to inform the public that is not so. So your child can remain at Jonathan Grant, and both academically, physically, chess-wise, we have a full package at Jonathan Grant. But I want to highlight the science and agricultural department for their achievements team. We were joint winners for an initiative by Water, where we won the cash prize of $75,000, or I believe it was $150,000 cash prize. So you can click on the link below. The link shows you different achievements we have made. So you can click on the links below and look at the stories. It tells you the achievement, the achievements we have garnered over the past 4 or 5 years. One of the persons who have been instrumental in all of these achievements is Miss Powell. And she is partnered by her head of department, Mrs. Lawrence. So the students and teachers have worked relentlessly day and night to be one of the top in the science arena in Jamaica. Next, we want to highlight Master Teacher Tracy Ann Hall, who is one of the top automobile instructors, teacher, in Jamaica and in the Caribbean. In fact, in recent years, she entered a competition and made the finals. The finals was held in Dubai, you know, and she put Jamaica and Jonathan Grant on the map as it relates to technology in the automobile sector. You know, she has a wealth of experience. I think she has over 18 years of experience. And Jonathan Grant is blessed to have her. Again, you can look in the comment section and click on the link. So Dr. Ankle have put together a lot of initiative, a lot of intervention program at Jonathan Grant to make the school what it is today. And like I said, chess is one of those such intervention program. I would recommend more students at Jonathan Grant to become a part of the chess club. One of the significant things have happened at Jonathan Grant is the CSEC and CAPE results. You know, for a non-traditional high school, the results are tremendous, and no wonder in the clip that we are about to see, Jonathan Grant's principal, you know, dancing, and you know, he's just excited over the tremendous achievements we have made since he came on board. We also started our sixth form program, you know, and it's one of the top sixth form program in the country, you know, especially among non-traditional high schools. So the teachers have put together a package, and I don't think the wider Jamaica saw this package, so I thought it was prudent to highlight the package that the teachers have put together to, you know, for Child's Month. So I wanted to take a look and enjoy the presentation. God bless you.
May is celebrated as Trans Month, and for Trans Month 2020, the theme is Unplug Negativity, Connect Positivity. Thing. Hey JG.
Celebrate National Children's Day.
Be reminded, we celebrate you every day, created for excellence. And I just want you to listen on these words that I'm about to tell you. Jonathanites are create waves at the ocean, yeah. Positivity and kindness are the new explosion. No bother cause no commotion. Positive vibes will be everybody motion. Peace our slogan. Never see a foe so strong, Jonathan. Never see a foe so strong. And during this pandemic, during this COVID-19 period, I know you might be feeling insecure. You might be feeling scared. You might be hearing, I wish you were not born. Unplug all of that. We are unplug all of the negativity. You might be hearing, you are ugly. Dash with that. You might be feeling depressed. We not work with that. You might be feeling as if you want to run away. We are plugging positivity. You might be hearing, you are worthless.
Unplug negatives. Connect the positive.
I am here today to bring you some positive thoughts about yourself. First one is, I have faith in you.
You are creative.
Believe in you.
We enjoy your company.
Are important and you make a difference.
You are loved.
All your endeavors, always remember our word of affirmation. You are created for excellence.
Thank you for contributing to the Jonathan Grant High School family. Your ideas matter. Are you where you celebrate?
See my t-shirt. JG until me leave Earth. Confidence come first. Ask question and you will learn.
Stop fret your head. We are going to fight for you like Mike Tyson. You're gifted and talented. Go and study. I just keep motivated. That's a wrap.
My name is Tracy Ann Hall. I am a teacher at Jonathan Grant High School, where I currently teach automotive technology. Jonathan Grant High School is located in the heart of Spanish Town. It is a wonderful school because we get the opportunity to enrich the lives of so many children. When I was in high school, I enjoyed motor vehicle. I had such passion for the cars and trucks that I saw on the road, and I did automotive technology.
Give them a break, no man.
When I went into the garage after leaving high school, there were a lot of men that were shocked to see a female in the garage. People observe you working and they realize how good you are, and they eventually break down that wall. While working, I continued studying, and after that, I decided I would love to teach.
Good afternoon, students.
Good afternoon.
After she came here and she started, then it was very obvious that here was a woman in a man's world, as I would put it, but knows exactly what she was doing.
What is missing from that core intersection?
So I have to integrate different methods of teaching based on the fact that we have students who have different learning styles. So I use field trips. I integrate music into the class, which is very fun for the students, where they write their lyrics based on the topics that I'm teaching.
We have general service and we're going to do some electrical work on that car.
Practical part, teach students about how to actually pull the parts down, to repair it, and to fix it back up.
When students come here to us, they come from various backgrounds. They need to be guided on the right pathway. And some of them do not have this away from school. So teachers...
Automotive technology is very expensive, and I have partnered with two automotive businesses.
The partnership involves us providing a scholarship annually, and we had a student from Jonathan Grant, David Wallen, who's now a part of our team.
In my community, everywhere you turn, there's somebody fixing a vehicle. So that's how I came into the field of automotive. I like to say great thanks to Tracy and all. She boosts me a lot. She always says that, David, come on, you can do it.
The other partnership that I have is with Jagas.
Once the students complete training, they can come right into the Jamaican German Automotive School to complete their training at a higher level.
I attended Jonathan Grant for 5 years, and with her help, I was able to come to Jagas and further my career.
The students, they ensure that they donate items such as roll-on clothing items. At the end of the school year, what we usually do is to go to a children's home or the infirmary, and we give out these items. We also have a street feeding program. Students go on the road and we take out 25 lunches every week. So homeless persons, persons who are old and sick that are on the road, and that surely teach them that it's important to give back to society.
She sees something that needs to be done, and it can be done. She doesn't stop until it is actually done.
She worked assiduously to get a sidewalk built, and that is being utilized not just by members of the school, but by members of the community.
What I love about teaching is the fact that I get to motivate, inspire. You know, you have children who would have lost their way, and you are there at that time to see them on the right path. When I call my students who have left many years ago, and you know, they say, Miss Hall, I'm now married, I have my children, I'm working. That's joy to me.
So you get in the car and you're on your way, or so you think, and then you hear that sound, or sometimes no sound. You know what I'm talking about. You know that weird one, or those weird ones that make you go, what is wrong with the car? We've got automotive technology teacher at Jonathan Grant High School, actually master teacher, Tracy Ann Hall, who's going to help us this morning to figure things out. So we learn something before we take the car to the mechanic, or maybe something we can fix ourselves and we don't need to go to the mechanic in Tracy Ann, maybe?
Right.
Morning, how are you?
Good morning.
You're a master teacher.
Yes.
What does that mean?
It means that you're appointed by Jamaica Teaching Council and Ministry of Education as an outstanding teacher who has gone beyond the call of duty. Mm-hmm. We have currently have about 30 mm-hmm. master teachers in Jamaica.
And so you've been in your area of speciality for mm-hmm. 18 years.
Yes.
You've taught at other schools.
Right.
You've also taught at Jagas, which is a
German automotive school.
Right. So Tracy, and I'm to understand that anything that happened on your car, you can
yes.
know is what I want?
Yes.
You fix it yourself?
Definitely.
You don't take it to no mechanic?
Never.
I need Tracy on speed there. All right, let's get in the car, Kadine. We're going to figure out, Tracy, and you're going to help us figure out some of these sounds. All right, the first one is, hold the steering wheel. That sounds like a timing bell, this thing. Noise at startup.
No, that wouldn't be a timing bell.
I knew that. Come again. Please again, Kaz. Please.
That sounds like a serpentine belt. Actually, it's usually Jamaicans call it the fan belt, because first time it used to drive the fan. So currently they...
I'm sorry, used to what?
Drive the fan, the cooling fan. But now...
Drive the fan?
Yes, but it doesn't... The fan is electrically controlled now. So it's the serpentine belt. So once it is slack, or if it's too tight, you'll hear the bearings getting damaged, so you'll hear that louder sound.
Wasn't I close? I said belt.
Yeah,
I just chose the wrong belt. How do you know when your steering wheel fluid
okay.
is low?
You can, well, actually, it shouldn't be low. If it's low, you have a leak, definitely. So you'll feel it
when
in
you
the...
you say it shouldn't be low, what do you mean?
Because...
Once you put it in...
Once you put it in, it should not go down.
For how long?
For couple of years. Mm-hmm. I mean, it stays, yes, it stays like 4 years. You won't have to, you just ensure once you see it going down, you know that there's a leak or the steering pump is defective.
Okay.
But again, you'll feel that in your steering. Right. So not just hearing it, but you'll feel the difference.
But
in
what
your
will
steering.
You hear?
Usually, you can hear
like a friction sound.
It's a little rough sound.
Yeah.
But again, it's more of a feeling.
Yeah.
It's more of a feeling.
So the steering is stiffer than. Is she dropping out of the car?
Is you in the car?
Yes, but I'm driving. You can't drop out as a passenger. Jeez, I'm Trace. All right, we appreciate this. Just stuff to listen out for on your vehicles, especially for the ladies from. A lady who knows all about cars, Tracy Ann Hall, master teacher and automotive technology teacher at Jonathan Grant High School. Thank you for your insight this morning.
You're
much
welcome.
Appreciated, and thank you for driving.